Hello everyone, we are going to see a demonstration on how a Creo model can be converted into an intermediary file format which can be imported in Revit. To convert the model, the user must install our Creo to Revit exporter tool in their system. Now open the desired Creo model in the application. Here you can see I have opened a Creo model named ASM0001. Now, I'm going to save the Creo model in BIMDeX BXF file type. Just click File in the main menu, select Save As option to get displayed to a pop-up screen. The user can select the location to save the BXF file and select the name of the BXF file. I'm going to name it after the Creo model, so you can relate this BXF file and now select the type. Here you can see the type BIMDeX.BXF file. It will get listed out only if you have installed with our Revit exporter tool. Once you select the file extension BXF, just click OK. Now comes the best part, the configuration of the BXF file that you wanted to be get exported. You can get displayed to the export to BXF pop-up screen here. Our tool is not just exports the diagram of the model, it also exports the model with its properties. In export to BXF pop-up screen, we can configure the .bxf file to get exported. In exclude components, it has two checkboxes, ignore internal component and ignore hidden component. You need to check and uncheck the required checkboxes. Whereas ignore internal component will ignore all the internal part and assembly components in the model while exporting as BXF file. And the ignore hidden components checkbox will give you the option to ignore all the hidden components. In customize export, you can customize based upon the user needs. Just click on the customize export button. It will take you to a pop-up screen. Here you can see the customize export grid contain the list of all components within their name, volume, type and quantity. Customize component drop-down option contain default mode, component name, volume, quantity and component type. By selecting component name, you can search and filter out the required components by name. For example, here using wildcard, enter 5 in the search box and click on the search button. It will list all the component name having 5 in their name. Click on refresh button to reset the filter options. By selecting volume, you can search and filter out the required component using symbol drop-down. For example, here by selecting lesser than symbol from symbol drop-down and the type 427 in search field and click on a search button. Now you can see it will list all the components which has a volume lesser than input value 427. Then click on refresh button to reset the filter option. By selecting quantity, you can search and filter out the component based on the required quantity using symbol drop-down. So select equal to symbol from symbol drop-down and type 1 in search field and click on a search button. You can see it will list all components having quantity equal to 1. By selecting component type, you can search and filter out the components based on part and assembly from drop-down respectively. Also, you can see the option for select component. You can select the component in the model preview. For example, here by selecting few components from model tree, select components get highlighted in green color. Click on OK. Will list only selected components in the grid. Also, you can see component details in the panel available in bottom of UI. Click on refresh button to reset the filter option. In bottom of UI, you can see options for check all and uncheck option, which will check all or uncheck all listed components respectively. Simplified representation. This option reads all the simplified representation available in the model and it will populate it to the user. Based on the user selection, the selected simplified representation will be made as active one and the geometry extraction takes place. Here we have a default simplified representation option and I am selecting it. And the next option is coordinate system. It will list all created coordinate system in model. And next, parameter selection. Now we need to set the parameter selection option. There are two options, all parameter and custom choice. We can either select all parameter or custom choice based on the requirement. It will extract all parameter information available in the paths and assemblies. When you select custom choice and click on expand option on the right side of the option, you will get a pop-up screen with assembly and part parameter. You can select the desired parameter to be extracted and select OK to apply. Here I'm selecting all parameter option to extract. Once all the export configuration has been done, then click on the export button at the bottom of the screen. The model will get exported into an intermediary file format called .bxf at the selected location we have chosen. Generally, it will take a few seconds to a minute, depends on the size of the model. As you can see, the export has been completed with log report. I have saved the exported file in desktop. Open Revit, you can import .bxf file either in a project or family based on requirement. Here I'm selecting family with generic template. Once you install our BIMDeX Revit importer plugin, you will see BIMDeX tab having an import option. Click on that import button, you can select the export BXF file from Creo. Also, you will be having option for import type as flat subassembly, flat part, and complete assembly for hierarchical import respectively. Here I'm selecting complete assembly and click on open. Generally, it'll take a few seconds to a minute, depends on the size of the model. As you can see, the import has been completed. Now let me compare both the model. You could see the Creo model, which I've exported into .bxf file and imported in BXF in Revit. You can see the geometry is very much the same. The exported model follows the same hierarchy and parameters of the Creo model. The assemblies and the elements will be exported with the model hierarchy.
Thanks for watching.